to Aging Matters. This is a program that is provided by the Berks County Area Agency on Aging, and I'm your host, Ann Barlet, Public Advocacy and Outreach Manager for the Area Agency on Aging. Our show this evening is called Living Well as You Age, and we've got a variety of things to discuss, and my guest with me this evening is Martha Sitler, and she is the Vice President of Education for Berks Encore. So thank you for being here. Welcome, Martha.
Thank you for having us.
I think that you and I can fill 30 minutes rather quickly, so we're going to talk really fast. No. Living well as you age, it can be many components, but tonight we're going to focus specifically on some health and wellness, evidence-based educational programs, both physically and non-physical, more or less an educational piece. And the first thing we wanted to start with, we have programs in Berks County that are evidence-based that are focused on fall prevention.
Correct.
And we're going to talk about two specifically, Matter of Balance and Healthy Steps for Older Adults. And why we want to start with that, I think that I have some statistics to share to prove a little bit about falls and fall prevention and the importance of learning as much as we can as we age to prevent falls. Just a couple of facts I found, Martha, before our presentation was every 29 minutes, so during the show, an older adult dies from a fall. And every 14 seconds, an older adult is treated in an emergency room for a fall-related injury. Also, did you know that 1 in 3 Americans fall every year? Falls are the leading cause of both fatal, as we mentioned, and non-fatal injuries for people age 65 and older. Mm-hmm. And one last one, because we could go on with stats, but almost half of the people who enter nursing homes do so because of a fall, because after the fall, they can't stay in their own home because of the fall or the complications associated with it. So our goal is to help you to learn a little bit more about these two particular evidence-based programs that are going to help people and hopefully make you more aware of things to help prevent falls so that we don't have some of those statistics so we can lower those statistics. Right. So Martha, let's start first with the Matter of Balance class. And obviously the word balance is in there, which is key to not falling. So tell us about the structure of the class, length, size, you know, and the key components.
As you said, Anne, a fall can certainly change someone's life completely and very quickly, and can be a risk for death. So things that we can do, and some people have the assumption that, oh, you're getting older, you're going to fall. It's just, they go hand in hand, and they don't. There are things we can do to prevent a fall. And one thing that you mentioned a few minutes ago was being aware of your surroundings, being aware of fall risks. In Matter of Balance, we talk about something called faulty behavior, spelled F-A-L-L-T-Y. Okay. Faulty behaviors, which we all do. We all do things that we know we've been doing for years. We haven't fallen yet, but they are risky. Mm-hmm. And some of those things might be going up and down staircases without holding on to the railing, or wearing those fuzzy slippers that are slippery on the bottom and might come off our feet. So just some things that that we need to be more aware of the risks and the dangers in doing those. We also encourage people to look around their own homes and to find things in their home or outside their own home that could be changed to make their home more safe. Mm-hmm. So the Matter of Balance class is actually an 8-week program. We talk a lot about changes that you can make in your home, changes you can make in your own behaviors, and changing your attitude. Sometimes as people become more frail, they say, oh, I can't do that anymore. I can't walk outside because I might fall, or I can't go to church, or I can't go to the senior center, or I can't go exercise anymore. But we do know that if you don't exercise and you don't go out and you don't socialize, that you are going to deteriorate physically and mentally. So we do want you to be able to continue to do things that you want to do and that you enjoy doing, but you have to do them safely. So we, during the mm-hmm. 8-week class, we look at ways to do things more safely.
Okay. So tell us about, so it's an 8-week class, mm-hmm. about how much at in each session, time-wise?
They're each 2-hour sessions.
Okay.
And a lot of it is, it's not lecture. A lot of it is class discussion, because participants in the class learn from each other as well and share ideas, and this has worked for me, and kind of encourage each other to try some things, or to attend a class, or to participate in Tai Chi or yoga or something. Mm-hmm.
As an ongoing
plan. Right, to help their balance.
Yes.
Right.
So in the classroom, it's a classroom style setting.
Mm-hmm.
Each week, I'm assuming there's different highlights, different topics in terms
different
of engaging folks
week.
In the discussion
right.
about.
And one of the pieces
said.
That we do each and every week is some exercises. And I know that
yes.
we're going to have a video very shortly
okay.
of some, they're very simple exercises, but they've, as Ann said, it's evidence-based. They've been created by doctors and physical therapists mm-hmm. to target muscles that need to be strengthened in order to prevent a fall, or
okay.
maybe to help you get up from a fall, because we do some things with our arms as well.
Okay.
So we
roll the film,
sure.
the video.
This
is taken from one of the Matter of Balance classes, and so we have a little clip of some of the different exercises, if we can show that now. Thank you. That was fun to watch. But I do want to comment. I noticed in the class that there were all kinds of folks. We had obviously men and women, but I think it's great that the people who were participating in that signed up, because you can see there was a walker, there's a lady mm-hmm. in a wheelchair, so really anybody can participate
Absolutely.
In that class.
Absolutely.
And we saw some seated exercises mm-hmm. and some standing exercises. So just give us a little bit about what we saw, what
right.
they were doing, what the purposes.
The seated exercises are usually done first, and a lot of them are just range of motion kinds
okay.
of things for stretching and flexibility, because we do know that if you're not flexible and you go to bend over and pick something up, you're more likely to fall. Or if you reach over your head to get something out of a cabinet, you're more likely to lose your balance and fall. So we work on flexibility things first, and we move to some strengthening of some target muscles, especially lower leg and around the ankles, which help to deliver that information about the terrain you're walking on. Mm-hmm. We do some leg strengthening exercises, the upper legs, the quads, that help you get up and down out of chairs, because we know that people who can't get up and down out of chairs easily, or up and down off the toilet, or up and down out of a car, are more likely to fall. We know that's a risk factor, so we work on those muscles. And the standing exercises, you saw me doing a lovely version of dancing there. But we do some sidestepping, and we do some kind of a box step to help improve your balance. Because we do those motions when we're in the kitchen, when we're in the bathroom getting dressed or combing our hair, we do those motions, and that's where a lot of people fall, just doing common things at home. Mm-hmm. So, so they're just very simple.
Anybody can sign up. These classes are public, available for anybody.
Yes.
And is there a fee or charge for
this? There is no fee for these programs, and we have been very thankful to work with the Reading Hospital Trauma Center, who also recognizes that geriatric falls are their number one reason that people end up in the trauma center.
Okay.
Number one reason. So they take it very seriously. So they provide the books for all of the participants and the space for a lot of our classes.
Okay.
And we have a great partnership with Reading Health System.
Good. Staying with the same theme about fall prevention, there's another evidence-based class that we have in Berks County. And ironically, Martha and I are both trainers in this program called Healthy Steps for Older Adults. Why don't you tell us a little bit about that structure that's available for folks to take?
That program also covers many of the same things. It's a shorter format for folks that say, what are we going to talk about for
eight weeks
or 2 hours a week? And I'll guarantee that the classes go quickly.
Mm-hmm.
But for those who don't want to spend that much time, we do have a shorter version, and the Healthy Steps for Older Adults class is a four-hour class, and it can be all in one day, or it can be split into 2 days. We do have a class coming up through the Boscov's Campus of Courses. You can check out that schedule. That will be the first Tuesday and Thursday in October at Boscov's North. And you can contact the Campus of Courses.
I was going to say, that's advertised typically. That's an ad in the newspaper.
So
if anybody gets the
Or you can stop at any Boscov's or call any Boscov's for information about it. Again, that's a free program that is done in conjunction with the area agency and with the Pennsylvania Department of Aging. And we will be happy to have anyone join that class.
Now tell us more, because in that there's a little bit of although there are many same topics,
know,
we want to improve balance, strength, flexibility for fall prevention. In that one, there's also three physical skills screenings that are done.
Correct. And we do that early in the program usually. We do three, as you know, we do three screenings to help assess people's risk of falling. And these are not things we made up. These are actually
touch your nose
being done through some doctor's offices. I've had people say, "Oh yeah, my doctor did those same three screenings," and they're well-known tests to assess a person's risk for falling. One of them, as I said, is your ability to stand up from a chair, and without having to use your arms and push off and things like that. So one of the tests that we do is have people sit in their chair, cross their arms, or they can put them out in front of them, and
don't hit your knees.
Stand up and sit down, stand up and sit down as many times as they can in 30 seconds. And some people think, oh, that's going to be easy, and they can do about two. You know, if you've got knee problems or leg problems, or you haven't really tried that, but that's one.
Well, again, I think we got in other habits, so we're used to pushing off on things
or
not really building
the
muscle.
Table in the restaurant or whatever.
Yeah.
But we should be able to stand without using our arms, ideally. Another one is called, that one's called the sit to stand. Another one is called the get up and go, which again, you get up from a chair, you walk a path on the floor, which is marked out to 8 feet, just walking straight ahead, turn around, mm-hmm. come back, turn around again, and sit down. And we see how long that takes you. And obviously someone who kind of shuffles along or takes a long time to get up out of their chair to begin with is going to take quite a long time to do that. But their gait, their mm-hmm. speed, yep. and their safety to do that is very indicative mm-hmm. of their fall risk. And the last one is a balance test where we ask you to hold on to the back of a chair or to a table and to get your balance on 1 foot.
And sounds easier said than done,
easier
right?
Easier said than done. Get your balance on 1 foot mm-hmm. and while you're still holding on. And then as you feel that you've got your balance, gradually let go of the chair so that you are standing on 1 foot. And we time you to see how long you can do that. Actually, the maximum, we let you quit if you can do it for 15 seconds. But I would say
we have a challenge. Hold on and yeah. see if we can time ourselves when we go home and balance tonight.
But most people can do it for about 2 seconds. Yep. That one's really not too good. So, you know, you can try that at home sometime, but do it in a safe spot with somebody there to protect you so you don't fall. But those are three skill tests that are part of this program. We also do some exercises. Mm-hmm. Again, it's important to keep your muscles strong and to have some flexibility. So there
and
are
I think the other thing you mentioned, just like Matter of Balance, they're looking at their home environment and healthy steps for older adults and kind of what's in the path for falling, what can we change and do. But I also think it also addresses some of the other issues that people don't think about involved in falling medications.
Yes.
And nutrition and some other issues, which we won't go in, but are all part of the program. Right. So again, that's out there. And if you want more information, we will show Martha's contact information at the end of the show so you can write that down and check and see where any of these classes are being offered here in Berks County. We're going to change focus a little bit here in the few minutes that we've got. There are two other evidence-based classes, and they are... one is called chronic disease self-management, and the other is called diabetes self-management. And the two key words in both of those are self-management. So these are other classes, and I'm going to ask you again to give us the layout, the structure, the sponsorship, and a little bit about it about each. I do have a book here. I'll show it while you then talk about it, is that this is the book that is used called Living a Healthy Life with Chronic Conditions. Mm-hmm. And this book is used in both of those classes, in chronic disease self-management and diabetes self-management. And it is a useful tool both in that some classes we utilize the book for some discussions and mm-hmm. research and things like that. And others we use because it's a good resource book.
Right.
So why don't you tell us, pick the chronic conditions if you want to start with that. And
both of the classes are geared for people, seniors, but of any age and of any ability who want to better manage to live well with their chronic condition.
Okay.
Whether that's heart disease, whether that's COPD, arthritis, mm-hmm. digestive problems, or diabetes. Either of these programs is going to be helpful for anyone struggling with or coping with an ongoing condition.
And Martha, one of the first questions, because I was looking in the book to find something, I didn't quickly find it, but people will say, well, how can we have a class on, I've got arthritis, and somebody else says, I don't understand how this is going to mesh.
Right, and a lot of people feel that way, but at the very first class, we talk about how does your chronic condition affect your life? And everyone's always surprised to find out that my arthritis makes me tired and I can't do what I want to do, and maybe your heart condition makes you tired and you can't do what you want to do. Or someone with diabetes mm-hmm. says, well, I'm tired too and I can't do what I want to do. So we find a lot of common ground and we go from there. How can we deal with these problems by better taking care of our ongoing condition? So both of the classes are very helpful. We do have several of each of the classes coming up for the rest of this year. I had a couple statistics about diabetes.
Oh, please.
If you want.
Sure.
Diabetes seems to be kind of epidemic proportions, not just in Berks County, but certainly very much so here in Berks County. Statistics say that 30.3 million Americans, which is close to 10% of the population of the United States, is living with diabetes. The risk is even greater for people as they age. For people over the age of 65, more than 25% of Americans over 65 have diabetes. That's just people who have been diagnosed with diabetes. There are also an additional 84 million people who are at risk or have something called pre-diabetes. They used to say, you know, you're close to diabetes. So there are steps that they should be taking to lower those risks and to do something about it. So we encourage you to call, get information about these classes to help you deal and manage.
And I'm just going to repeat a couple of things. Both classes are 6 weeks in length, 2.5 hours each week.
Right.
The diabetes one obviously focuses more on tools and things that are related specifically
menu planning
to diabetes, healthy eating, menu
carbohydrates, okay. Things like that.
And the chronic disease self-management is all kinds of things that will help somebody better manage whatever chronic conditions
including
they have.
Including healthy eating, including exercise, but as well as dealing with stress, better communication with your family and with your doctor.
There's a couple of key components we won't let on tonight, but there's some things that folks do each week, from week to week, that really engage all of the participants. So if you want to be an active manager in helping to manage either a general chronic condition, one of the chronic conditions, or specifically diabetes, we suggest that you again look for classes in our area. With a few minutes left, we're going to take a little bit of a switch to. Did you want to share a testimonial on one of those CDS and PRDS and B classes, real quick?
We have a couple people who wrote notes following a recent class. One said that she enjoyed doing the action planning, which was one of the steps Anne alluded to. And we're also given a very good reference book, which is the book that Anne had showed. Another one said that she enjoyed the part about learning to read labels, planning menus, and how to live a positive life with her diabetes.
Because again, even stress we know affects any chronic condition, but particularly diabetes. So great, we've got some good, we've got folks that have really enjoyed both and learned some things from both of those classes. With 2 minutes left, we're gonna talk about one more quick, if you can put it in a sentence or two, sorry Martha, it's the Living with Arthritis Walk with Ease program that's also available.
This is a brand new to Berks County program. Again, we're working with Reading Health System and with Berks Visiting Nurses and some other organizations, and we're doing the Arthritis Foundation Walk with Ease program, which helps people warm up, do some stretching exercises, and then increase their ability to walk comfortably without pain in spite of arthritis or other debilitating conditions. So there are four classes starting this fall. Again, you can call me if you want more information, or call the Reading Hospital Helpline.
And like the length of the, is there a session
those
length?
Are 6 weeks, but there are three times a week.
Oh, okay.
There is also an online version of that class that you can take and walk on your own.
Okay.
But there's information on the Reading Hospital Helpline.
Well, we can see that theme of being physically active, doing something, whether it's walking or any kind of other exercise component, was certainly going to help prevent falls and stay upright, as it were, for
But it can
for
also
yourself,
be very beneficial for people with any chronic exactly. condition, and especially diabetes, to help lower their blood sugar by exercising.
Exactly, and balance everything out. So really, yeah. these are all great general health and wellness programs that are available to you, and all of them are free of charge, right?
All of them are free.
So please take advantage of those. We're on the last minute that we have. I'm going to ask for the contact information to be put on screen. Ask that you contact Martha Sitler. She is at Berks Encore with the phone number of 610-374-3195. To know when and where these classes are scheduled. And you can also actually check the Berks County Area Agency on Aging's website.
Right.
That's www.berksaging.org. You saw one will be advertised in the newspaper with mm-hmm. the Boscov's Campus of Courses. So hopefully you will look at one of those or many of those and find a good health and educational program for you. So that's about it. That's all the time that we have. Thank you so much for sharing that. I look forward to these programs being available in Berks County. And thanks for tuning in to Aging Matters.